And you think of human limitations. We use the tools of technology to amplify. If I'm walking down a icy cold street in Minnesota and I look at a house, I see a house. But if I look at it in infrared, I'll see windows that are blue, which means somebody put some money into putting double pane so the heat's not coming out, and a roof that's bright red, which means nobody put any insulation in there, and oh my God, the money's flowing right out through the roof. Seeing it with my normal eyes, nothing to be done. Seeing it with the infrared says, fix that roof tomorrow, because my gosh, you're just freezing inside, you're wasting all this money. So seeing things in new ways leads to action, because people have new information, new understanding. And when you intervene in something, you're going to go put new insulation in. The part John's talking about learning from an intervention. So did it go well or not so well? Every time you go to a doctor, the doctor's looking at you saying, should we cut or not cut? Will they die or not die? Very smart guy, John Tukey, looked around. He was the person that designed the statistical environment that said, when you introduce the polio vaccine, some kids are going to die because it will be interacting with their body. Can we design it in a way so the fewest die? Brilliant statistician. But you know, if you look around the world, people make decisions. And when they make decisions, they say, so what do I know? What do I anticipate will happen? Do I have enough information? Not really, but I'll decide, and a decision's made. And then the implications of the decision play themselves out. Who learns from, do we design it so that you learn from this, as John is suggesting? We do. So Tukey looked around to say, so what big interventions have we done? Polio was one, but every medical operation is an intervention. The patient will live or die. So there's a ranking. Plus plus means the patient lived. Minus minus means the patient died. Zero means, well, we couldn't really, nothing much happened as a result. And he went through hundreds of social interventions. Do we want to keep a teenage pregnant girl in school? How do we do it? People decide. And he discovered in almost all governmental and corporate interventions, nobody ever put the mechanism in that John's suggesting we do that keeps track of what the outcome was.
Yep, forensic.
It could be embarrassing. In fact, it probably is going to be embarrassing. So if we don't have the machinery embedded in what we do every day to track the results, we're off there saying, don't we think all propane buses would be good? Don't we think the trash collection box should be this? And in some cases, yes, and in some cases, no, but we don't have it designed now. But the computing and networking world can help us to figure out whether the intervention was a plus plus. So our goal is to try to use these new tools to decide in a better way how to improve our decisions. And everyone has to choose, do I eat this or not? Daddy don't smoke is the impact of broad social networks where all those that could be affected by your behavior can suddenly tell you something that might improve what you do. And the power of this is just at the beginning. We've watched the people of Tunisia tell the Tunisian government, the people of Egypt tell the Egyptians. We've watched people trying with their voice from their experience to explain to others what was the impact of decisions. And so far the votes have been coming in saying they've been bad and we're just not going to take this anymore. So it would be nice if we could add a more long-term substantial way. So we've had revolutions. We've altered the structure of the government, maybe. Now can we track the impact of this? We're at that moment right now to try to design this. And there are some frameworks that have been established. John and this project he's working on have frameworks that allow others to put their evaluations of the interconnectivity of a lot of the things that we live in, make things plainer. So I look at Scottsdale and I see an inefficiently laid out city with not very efficient water systems and a difficult way for public transportation, which excludes lots of people. Someone else with different eyes would see the energy flows in the city, or the material flows in the city, or the performance of the schools in the city. And if all these different ways of seeing could be unified to let someone new on the scene get a grip on it and be guided by someone who has experience in this and then make their own minds up, we could make a change in how we actually organize ourselves.